Some people always create their titles from scratch for every single video they are making. And that's not super efficient. That's like working extra hours for free, and I'm sure everyone would hate that. So why not set it up once and then just reuse it every time you're making a new video? First step, go to your effects library in the top left corner, then go to titles, and then use this text plus title, just drag it onto your timeline, just like so. Then you have the full flexibility to make the title longer or shorter, depending on your needs. For me, let's just stick to this 5 seconds. Then what I wanna do is go to the inspector in top right corner, and under text plus, click on this fusion icon. This will load up the title in the fusion page. And then from there, we can create our title. So first step that I'm gonna do is rename my title to subscribe. So speaking of subscribe, if you enjoy the content on this channel, feel free to hit the subscribe button right below this video somewhere down here. It's free, so why not do it? Then we have the font style, the color, size, whatever you want, maybe increase the tracking right here. And then let's go to layout and put that somewhere as a lower third. So something like that, and that is totally fine. So right now let's animate that title because we don't want just a stationary title, that would look boring. So let's animate that on and off screen, and we're just going to do that by using a simple transform node, something like that, that you can find up here. And what I'm gonna be doing in this transform node, I'm gonna set a keyframe on frame number 0 on center, and then move forward, let's go with like 16 frames, and then set another keyframe. So right now nothing happens because we haven't changed any values of our center position. So let's go back to our first keyframe, bring that over to the left to where it is right out of frame, something like that. And not just like right here where it disappears from the screen. Let's just bring this whole box off screen. So I mean this line right here, something like that. And that is because if we make our title bigger, if we add some more stuff to our title, that means it cannot get messed up because the whole screen is off screen. If that makes sense. And if we hit play right now, this would just come into frame, and then somewhere right here, we want to animate it off screen. So what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna go to center, set another keyframe, and then move to the end, and then put it off screen once again. And once again, I'm gonna do this with the whole transform box. So this will look something like this. So it's just a nice, simple animation. Right now, it stops very abrupt, and I wanna change that. So I'm gonna go to my spline window in the top right corner right here, and then I'm gonna go to transform and then select displacement. Then I'm gonna go to this zoom to fit button. And then what I'm gonna be doing is select the second keyframe and hit F on my keyboard, which will then just flatten this out so it doesn't stop abrupt. It comes to a nice easing end. And then I'm gonna do the same thing for that exact keyframe right here. I'm gonna flatten this so it starts very slow and then speeds up a bit. And we don't have to take care about this keyframe to end abrupt because it's off screen anyways and we cannot see that. Let's get rid of the spline window by just clicking the spline button in the top right corner. And then let's have a look to what this actually looks like. So, super simple. And you can add tons of different stuff. You could add masks, you could add backgrounds to your title, whatever. The same technique appears. So what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna left click and highlight all nodes except the media out node. We don't need that. Then I'm gonna right click on one of those nodes, on which one doesn't matter at all. Right click and then go to where it says macro and then create macro. And this window will pop up. First of all, we're gonna rename our macro, and let's just call this subscribe lower third. Then you have all those options, and depending on how many nodes you got in your node editor, you will have even more options, because basically all of those options that you can check on are the options that you have available in each node in the inspector. But let's take a closer look on what we actually need to change. If you cannot remember that, you can always click off this macro editor tool and select the node that you want to edit. And for me, it is the text node, so the template. But then I'm gonna go to my text and then I'm gonna see what exactly I need. And of course, I want to be able to change my text, text font, the font family, the color, size, tracking, and maybe even the spacing from the edit page. So if we collapse this, we see the template node, we see the transform one node, we see the path node, which basically is just the movement of the transform node, and the path one displacement. We don't have to take care of any of those transform one, path one, and path one displacement. So all we have to do is go to our template, and then right here, you can see all the different tabs that you have. So we have image, which is right here. Then we have text, which is right here. Then we have layout, which is right here. Transform shading and common, transform shading and settings. Just for you that you get a better overview of what's going on inside of this macro editor. And then because all of our changes are going to happen within that text window, we have to open up this text window and there we have it. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select style text because this is this window right here. Then font because we want to change the font. And then we want to change the style, which is basically right here, this drop-down menu. Then we want to select the color and we want to select green, blue, and alpha. Then of course, we want to be able to change our size. So we want to include the size as well and the tracking. And then we maybe even including the line spacing if we have another line of text right here, right below our subscribe text. Once you've done that, once you've gone through everything that you might want to include and to be able to edit off right off your edit page, then we want to hit close and it will ask you to save changes to macro tool one and then you want to select yes. Right now I'm going to save as subscribe lower third. And I'm not gonna save it in my macros folder. I'm gonna save it to my desktop. This is something I would recommend you to do as well. And all I'm gonna be doing now is hit save. And then we can actually tap out of DaVinci Resolve. And right now what we see on my screen is this subscribe lower third setting. And that's pretty much all you have to do. Right now, what I'm going to be doing is, when what I recommend you to do is to create a couple folders. First of all, starting with an edit folder. Then inside that edit folder, we want to create a new folder and call that titles. And in this titles folder right here is where I want to drag my subscribe lower third setting in. Then I'm going to close this. And right now is where the magic happens. So I'm going to right click this edit folder and select zip edit. This will just create a zip file from that edit folder. And right now with the zip file, I want to right click, go to rename, and then you might want to change the beginning. Let's go with awesome. And then change the ending from .zip to .drfx. If you hit enter now, it will ask you if you want to keep .zip or if you want to change to .drfx. And there, of course, you want to select use .drfx. And right now we have a awesome .drfx file that I would recommend to right click and duplicate. And that is because Resolve sometimes messes up the installation process and instead of installing this template, it will just delete it from your computer and there's no chance of recovery whatsoever. Creating a duplicate of a DRFX file is always recommended. And then with this DRFX file and DaVinci Resolve open, all I'm gonna do is double click that DRFX file and then it will ask me to install Awesome. This will add the selected template bundle to the effects library and there we want to hit install. And right now, if we jump into DaVinci Resolve, we can actually search for our title and that is called subscribe lower third. And if we drag that onto our timeline, we can see then we have nothing more to do, just drag and drop and reuse that as often as you'd like, just like this. and it's pretty easy. And if you want to change the color, you can totally do that right from the edit page. And using this technique will save you a ton of time down the road, because you don't have to take care about all the animation process, because, well, that's just already there. All you gotta do is maybe if you want to change the font and the color and the size, whatever the heck you want. All right, that's a wrap. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If so, please consider leaving a like and a comment down below. That would mean a ton to me. But anyways, I hope you're having a great day. See you on the next one. Bye.